Welcome to Pro Se Litigation, a lawsuit school. Yeah, we provide you tools, you do the work. That's what we're going to use from now on. We're making some changes in the house. Thanks to the attorneys for teachable.com who terminated my two online courses after 3.5 years. 3 years, I don't know. Anyway, and we're going to talk more about that in a different video. But the attorneys are making me grumpy. So what I've done, and I don't have time to be messing with them and trying to drag them into court, so I'm going to let other people do it. So what I've done is there's something on my website that I reduced to a very low price. And that price, that sale, is going to be good from today until the 7th to 7/23. The sale's gonna be over on the 7th. So that gives you a few days to, and I'm not going to talk about what it is on sale. You're gonna have to figure that out. And I'm not gonna talk about the price either, because my boss does not want to hear me talk about the price. And if I talk about the price, he's gonna get grumpy, and then I'll have to go to my website and get some papers to serve on myself. But that's how I'm going to punch back. I'm going to punch back by allowing a lot of people to get their foot in the door for a very small price to get some stuff done. There you go with that. WinInCourtNow.com, and I have the website at the end of all of my videos. For those people who call me and they haven't been to the website, then it lets me know that you didn't watch the whole video. You're going to have to run some laps. Okay, sorry. Welcome to the show tonight. I'm Coach Neighbors, and tonight our main subject is going to be the counterclaim, how to use it, when to use it, and what not to do. So we'll get to that. But before we get to that, now one of the things I want to say is that this sale package that's on sale takes care of both the kinds of issues that it handles. So don't get caught up in the words on the title. It'll have both types of issues. That, and the other thing that I want to tell you guys while I got your eyeballs and ears, is that you should always be watching the updated instructional videos. Any updated videos have new things that we've changed to make the product better. Updated instructional video is the most important video that you should watch. If you have a case in court, that video tells you, one of those updated instructional videos will tell you how to stop the state court process. And we're gonna talk about that tonight. But we're gonna call it the counterclaim, because that is the problem people have with the counterclaim. Now, if you're new to this program and you invest in a 42 USC 1983 civil rights package, then you need to be using the videos in that package, not all the other 400 and something videos. Because what you're doing is you're backing yourself up to the old stuff that we're not using no more. And you paid for the new stuff, but you're not using it because you didn't take the time to go watch the damn instructional video to understand how you need to use the documents in the package. So when people do that, they spend all that money and then they use it like it's a conventional document, and then pretty much get your ass kicked. So I'm just saying. And then people contact me all in a panic when they never watch the instructional video. I tell you in the videos, they're going to try and dismiss it under Rule 12B, even if it states a claim, because they're just going for broke. And most people get freaked out and don't even realize that it's easy to state a claim. All you gotta do is Google that shit. I'm just saying. It's easy to state a claim. So if you're using my stuff, you already state a claim, and they know it. But they're going to lie to your ass because they know you're not going to go do the damn homework, or you'd be coming at them in a different way. You'd be using the fire like you're supposed to be using it. The counterclaim, let's just get right to it. So the counterclaim, you cannot use the counterclaim if you're facing the eviction. If you're at the end of the road and they're about to push your butt out the door, you cannot use the counterclaim. And here's why. Now, I mentioned this in the video, but I didn't spend too much time on it. Apparently, they're missing it, or they think the counterclaim's a great way to go because you don't have to pay. If you're facing the eviction process, it's not a great way to go unless you have no other option. And here's the reason why. When you file a counterclaim, you're filing stuff in their case. So if I got your ass through the eviction process and you file a counterclaim, you're expecting those fools over there that's stealing your stuff to do the right thing and stop everything and say, oh, wait, here's a counterclaim. Oh, hell no, that's not what they're going to do. They're going to throw that shit on the table over there and leave it sit on the table over there. And then they're going to make a few phone calls to the sheriff department. They're going to move your ass up on top of the list for the eviction shit and see if they can get the people out there as quick as they can before they have to worry about any of that crap that you sent them. Now, there are some things that you can do if you're in that situation. Put a lien on your property. That's the best thing you can do with the lawsuit that you filed to deter those leeches from wanting to invest in your property. So if you're into this foreclosure and you're not facing the eviction process, then you can use the counterclaim without having to pay and use it to jack them in the face. But if you're facing the eviction process, you don't have time for that. And you may not want to do it anyway. You may just want to go ahead and file it in federal court and be done with it. If you're into this and you don't, you know. But I like to crush the state court process. Otherwise, the federal court will be stalling, trying to help them fools get your butt into the eviction process. That's how that works. You cannot use the counterclaim if you're facing the eviction process. It's not going to help you because you're asking them to police themselves when you do that. So in order to stop the eviction process, you have to file your lawsuit in state court and federal court. We don't remove the case either anymore. That's old time stuff. So I had a guy got himself in the eviction process, got jammed up because he tried to remove the case instead of doing things the way that we suggest that you do them, add the right parties to it, and make those, yeah. The counterclaim cannot be used if you're facing the eviction process. You have to file your stuff in state court as a new lawsuit. Then you have to file in federal court also. Now, we started out filing in federal court and then moving and doing all that stuff, but then federal court was stalling and allowing people to get to in the eviction process, so we had to change some things. And those things that we changed are the things that people are going to find in the updated instructional videos or any videos that have been updated. Before I leave, I want to show you guys the front page of the new website that I'm putting together to host my online courses on. Bam! And there it is. Pro Se Litigation Lawsuit School Online Courses. Yeah, is that's pretty. Oh, that's pretty. Take your legal coaching skills to the next level by mastering the basics of the non-conventional legal offensive strategies we use to stop the court process. With these comprehensive design courses, you'll learn everything that you need to know to teach others how to stop judges and attorneys in their track. Yeah, I worked hard on that yesterday. This is looking great. After struggling through Teachable, I got this. So, I haven't changed none of this yet. Oh, and meet your instructor. Damn, I got good looking and young. Okay, I think that's the stock picture. I don't think that's me. And I got to change all this stuff. So all this stuff is not changed yet, but this is going to be the new website where all of my online courses will be hosted. So you'll be able to go here. And then we have a blog section. We're going to have everything that we need to communicate. And I'm hosting this on my own WordPress site, so I don't have to worry about any attorneys trying to shut me down, because all they're doing is making me step up. So thank you guys for the value of sharing your time again. I'm really going to leave now. Good night.